Hello everyone. Today we are going to see the topic nature of management. That is, we have to find out whether we can consider management as a science or as an art or as a profession. How should we consider this management? So to know that, we are going to see first management as a science. So first of all, we should know the meaning of science. Science deals with the facts and findings, and it works on certain principles establishing a cause and effect relationship. So here it works on the facts and findings, and also there is certain principle on which the science is working. To know whether we can consider management as a science or not, we'll have to compare the features of science with that of management. So we are going to see that. The first one is systematic body of knowledge. Body of knowledge means what? It is a study material or the book available to study. So we have books to study physics, chemistry, botany, zoology and so on in the science. So do we have books for management? And of course, yes, we have the books for management, and there are study materials available to study management. So we can see that this feature of science is present in management. And the second one is, scientific principles are derived on the basis of logical and scientific observations. You can take any science principles. You might have studied your thumb rule. You might have studied your Newton's law. Everything we have studied till 10th at least. So we might have, like we can understand, like the gravitational force when they are explaining. It is not that on one fine day he threw the thing and then it fell on the earth. So he said that there is a gravitational force. It is not so. And he had some logic for that. And he tried it everywhere. And then he thought that, okay. And after observing so many things, then they have given the principles. Likewise, the management principles are also derived. It was not framed overnight. The management practitioners, they tried a lot, they analyzed a lot, and then finally they have framed the principles. So this feature, we can see that it is there in the management. And the next one is, principles are based on repeated experiments. So they continuously go for, if you have seen in the chemistry lab and all, if they are doing the experiments, continuously they will be doing. If the experiment is repeated many times, the results will be the same, and they repeat it many times, and then only they finally come. Like the experiments are based on certain principles, they have to do that, and then only they will declare that as a principle. Likewise, management also, it is not that only observing a few workers they have given the principles, or few management people they have given the principles. It has been applied on various people and various types of business organizations to find out whether this can be considered as a principle or not. So this management principles are also based on repeated experiments, but the results will not be the same. And the next one is universal validity. Science principles, wherever you are applying and whatever situation it is, and it works in the fixed conditions, and the results will remain the same. Whereas management principles, the application is to be changed according to the type of the organization, size of the organization. So the results of management experiments or the studies will not be the same. The simple reason being, it is applied on human being, and we know that no two human beings are identical to each other. So it differs. So we can say that the first two features of science is there in the management, and the next is not fully there in the management. So we can consider this as a science, but not as a pure science. This can be considered as a soft science, or as an inexact science, or as a social science.